She's a native New Yorker, but now calls Iowa home, and we are the benefit of that. Catherine Dreiss goes by Kay. She is a printmaker, a graphic design artist, who also shares a space here with your husband, Jeffrey Thompson, and we're going to talk about him in a bit. But I love your work and the way you combine all of these together. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Kay.
Well, I have been a printmaker since high school. I can thank a very inspiring high school teacher and a great high school curriculum for that. In that very small high school classroom, I had access to an etching press, silkscreen, even a lithography press, painting. I studied printmaking in college, but my major was in art history because I was very focused on the idea of spending my junior year in France, which I did, and I was exposed to the great art of Europe. And art history has informed my thinking, my subject matter since those days.
Tell us about the procedure. It is, you combine computer graphics and drawing, and the whole process is fascinating to me.
Well, I don't want to overload your audience with a lot of technical information, but I do feel that graphic design has become an integral part of my process because, and also printmaking has become a part of my graphic design process because when I was in New York, I took a class called Computer Silk Screening at the School of Visual Arts, and we were using Photoshop 2 on a Mac classic.
And
never having been a very comfortable drawer, I realized that by the, using the computer would be a means to an end.
All right. In addition to the wood cutting, you do silk screening?
I do silk screen and etching. I just finished teaching silk screen at the Des Moines Art Center, and it was so inspiring and fun to share those techniques with new students. And I am also teaching now intaglio at the Des Moines Art Center.
I will.
And you
but
teach
I
it
know
I teach computer graphics, also called digital media, and as well as form and concept, where I'm introducing young designers to the ideas of applying the principles of design to their artwork.
And I mentioned your husband. You share a loft,
okay,
space here at the Fitch Building. How does that work?
All right.
Very well. Occasionally fight over who does the dishes, just like at home. But we have been here at the Fitch Building way back when it was the BMS. We've probably been in this building for 13 years, and we've seen it change and evolve quite a bit.
What's next for you? Is this something that do you do in series?
I don't consider these series to be complete, but I haven't found the next one that I would like to do. I'm looking for that pose everywhere. I do think that maybe I need to go visit the Louvre or a visit to the Vatican may be in order, but not on schedule yet. I'm currently just starting a new series I'm really excited about. I'm calling it, sort of the working title is The Record Collection. And music has always been a very important part of my thought process. It's a constant soundtrack in our work. And lately, I have been having a lot of dreams about some of the songs that have been favorites for me. Interesting. I don't really put too much credence into dream symbolism, but it's made me think a bit about what dream symbolism can mean. So, and that my dreams have a soundtrack is also a little bit odd to me. So one of the prints that I've just started is called Come On, Come On, Oblivion, and it's based on a song by Matcha, and the song is about domination in a relationship. So that's what I'm working on now.
Well, we'll have to come back and see what develops.
Okay.
Kay, thank you so much. Fascinating work. And we're going to catch up with your husband as well. So
okay,
thank you very much. For KCCI, I'm Molly Cooney in the Artist Studio.
To see more of Catherine's work, be sure to check out MoberggGallery.com. And next week, Molly profiles Catherine's husband, studio mate, and equally talented artist.